Today we're going to take a look at the new features and changes in this latest release of Solus operating system, Solus 4.5, codename Resilience. In this video we're going to talk about all the versions that Solus offers, but we're going to show only the Plasma version. So, let's get started. One of the biggest changes in this new version is the new installer. The old installer was based on Python 2, which is now outdated and no longer supported. The new installer is based on Calamares, which is more modern and user-friendly installer. It also supports more file system, including ButterFS. Solus 4.5 comes with the latest version of Firefox, LibreOffice and Thunderbird. These are all the applications you need to get started on your new Solus installation. Solus now uses Pipewire as the default media framework. This should improve performance, especially for Bluetooth audio. Pipewire is also more flexible and extensible than Pulse Audio and Jack. Solus 4.5 now includes ROC 5.5 for AMD hardware. This provides GPU acceleration for applications like Blender and machine learning tools. This latest version ships with the Linux kernel 6.6.9 and Mesa 23.3.2. This update brings improved hardware support and performance. Solus 4.5 introduces a new XFC edition. This is a lightweight alternative to Budgie and Plasma edition. It's perfect for users who want a fast and efficient desktop experience. The Budgie desktop is known for its clean and modern interface. In Solus 4.5, the Budgie desktop has a number of new features, including Dark Theme Preference Support. This allows you to set your preferred dark or light theme for all applications. Budgie Trash Applet. This applet makes it easy to empty your trash and browse its content. New Notification System Improvements. These improvements should make the notification system more responsive and efficient. Better Fuzzy Searching. This makes it easier to find applications and files using the Budgie search bar. The GNOME desktop is a popular choice for Linux users. In Solus 4.5, the GNOME desktop has a number of new features including SpeedNator extension. This extension speeds up animation in GNOME shell. New GTK theme. This theme provides a more modern and unified look for GNOME applications. New file chooser with grid view. This makes it easier to browse file in the file chooser. New accessibility settings. These settings make it easier for users with disabilities to use GNOME. Security menu in GNOME settings. This menu provides access to security settings. The Plasma desktop is a feature-rich and customizable desktop environment in Solus 4.5. The Plasma desktop has a number of new features, including new default theme. This theme provides a more modern and unified look for Plasma applications. Support for double click to open. This makes it easier to open files and folders. New folder open behavior in Dolphin. This behavior makes it easier to open multiple folders in Dolphin. The XFC desktop is known for its stability and performance. In Solus 4.5, the XFC desktop has a number of new features, including traditional desktop layout. This layout is familiar to users of other desktop environments. Qjit GTK theme. This theme provides a modern and sleek look for XFCE. Papyrus icon theme. This theme provides a more modern and polished look for XFCE. Blueman for Bluetooth support. This tool makes it easy to connect to Bluetooth devices. Beta release. This means that XFCE edition is still under development, but it's usable for most users. Solus 4.5 Resilience is a major release that brings a number of new features and improvements. It's a great choice for users who are looking for a stable, user-friendly and powerful operating system. I hope you enjoyed this video on Solus 4.5 Resilience. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. And as always, if you find this video useful, please like, share and subscribe.